Hey there, Mick Schaefer and Leif Lysak here with your high school roundup rewind from the week that was. We begin, well, so many games to choose from, but you have to begin with number one.
You have to, if you go numerically.
Numerically, yeah. And like news lead-wise, you got to go with Rockhurst and Blue Springs. Number one against number two in the city. This game was at Rockhurst. Tony Severino lost his voice like in fourth hour today. Second quarter, Blue Springs up 3-0. Big third down conversion here. Chase Donahoe, the coach's son. Perfect strike to Trey Wheaton. That's a first down. Same drive. Pitch goes to Jalen Ivey. He rumbles in for six. It's 10-0 Wildcats. Still in the second, another third and long for Blue Springs. This time it's Caleb Marquez who keeps the Wildcat drive alive. And then wild play here. Watch closely. Jalen Ivey looks like he's down. But the whistle doesn't blow, and Ivy just strolls in for the score. Apparently landed on the defender. You figure that out. 17-0 Wildcats at the half. They would win 24-7. They'll be the new number one team in the city.
Platte County making the trip to number nine, Liberty. This one actually played at Liberty High School. Pirates up one, looking for more. Justin Mitchell, TJ Guillory for the first down. Next play, John Watts gets the handoff, and he goes 30 yards untouched. For the touchdown, Pirates now up eight. Crazy series of events here. Platte County call for intentional grounding in the end zone. That cuts the lead to six. A big return on the punt following the safety is going to set up this. Liberty, a huge play. Tanner Swenson burns the entire defense right there with a touchdown. So in a matter of 20 seconds, Blue Jays go down one, up one, or down eight, up one, but Platte County wins at 38-30.
We take you to Western Shawnee, home of the Sombreros and a golf course with a lake for a driving range. Middle school band out for Mill Valley, hosting Blue Valley. Huge matchup in Kansas. Ben Hartman, his seventh touchdown catch of the season already. It's 7-3 Mill Valley. Brody Fleming, gonna throw it. No, he's gonna run it. No, he's gonna throw it. That's Ben Hartman's eighth touchdown catch of the season. Through four games, 14-3 Jags. Blue Valley answers with a, what else? Quick slant, yeah. Matthew Dercher to Cade Green, and Cade is gone for 65 yards and a touch, 14-10 game. Next drive, Dercher goes up top to Harrison. Van Dyne, 17-14, Blue Valley retakes the lead. Mill Valley would answer. Watch this play, Fleming all but sacked, Fleming all but tripped, flings it, Hartman, huge play. Sets up this Brady Garrison plunge. A few plays later, Mill Valley back on top, 21-17. But Blue Valley comes back with another big play. The throwback screen to William Evans. That's another touchdown, and the Tigers will roll in the second half. 45-28. They are still undefeated in the driver's seat in the EKL. That'll do it. Be sure to join us next Friday night at 10 o'clock right here on the High School Roundup. Leif, will you be here?
Yes, in spirit at least.
In spirit at least. That's all we can ask.